So where do the double angle formulas come from? At this point, let's assume that we know the sum formula for sine, cosine, and tangent. Let's use these to verify these double angle formulas. So in these formulas for our sums, what we're going to do is assume that alpha and beta are the exact same. So we're going to call both alpha and beta equal to theta. Don't get hung up with these different names. So we have sine of, instead of alpha plus beta, we can say theta plus theta. And over on the right-hand side, we're going to replace each one of these alphas and each one of these betas with thetas. All right, so on the left-hand side, we have sine of two thetas on the inside. Theta plus theta makes two thetas. And then over on the right-hand side, what we can do is we have sine of theta times cosine of theta plus another sine of theta times cosine of theta. The order is reversed here, but being that these are multiplied together, you can reverse that very easily. So that's two sine of thetas times cosine of thetas. And that's our formula for the double angle of sine. Next, with cosine of alpha plus beta, we can say, first of all, that's cosine of theta plus theta, or this is where we get our cosine of two thetas over on the left-hand side. Over on the right-hand side, we're going to replace in each one of these alphas with a theta and each one of the betas with a theta as well. So we have cosine of theta times cosine of theta minus sine of theta times sine of theta. As you may notice here, we have cosine times cosine with the exact same thing being plugged in. We can represent that with an exponent saying two copies of the same thing multiplied together. The same thing with sine of theta times sine of theta, we can represent that with sine squared of theta. So cosine of two theta is equal to cosine squared of theta minus sine squared of theta. Let's use that definition over here on the left-hand side. We can rewrite the exact same thing that we just had. But then what we can do is we can get a different version of the same formula by replacing the cosine squared with one minus sine squared of theta. And where that's coming from is the Pythagorean identity. To substitute in for cosine squared of theta with one minus sine squared of theta, because sine squared of theta plus cosine squared of theta equals one. It's just a little rearranging of that Pythagorean identity. You can replace cosine squared of theta with this one minus sine squared of theta. Dropping our parentheses here, we have one and then two copies of sine squared of theta being combined together here, both being subtracted. So we can say that's one minus two sine squared of theta. Now over on the right-hand side, we can say something very, very, very similar by starting out with cosine squared of theta minus sine squared of theta. This time though, we would replace in the sine squared of theta. Using again the Pythagorean identity, we can replace that with one minus cosine squared of theta is equivalent to sine squared of theta. As we distribute our negative from out in front of this set of parentheses, we're going to get a negative one. But then as we distribute the negative to this negative cosine squared, that the double negative makes addition. So we have cosine squared from out in front. And then remember, this is plus cosine squared of theta again. So that's two cosine squared of thetas with this minus one brought along. So that's a third version for the double angle formula for cosine. And one more here, let's take a look at tangent of alpha plus beta, which we're going to replace this with tangent of theta plus theta, saying that alpha and beta are the exact same. So that'll give us tangent of theta plus tangent of theta in our numerator over one minus tangent of theta times tangent of theta. So our numerators, we have two of the same thing being added together. So we can say that's two copies of tangent of theta added together. In our denominator, we can say that's one minus, and then we have tangent times tangent, two of the same things. We can represent that with an exponent. So that's where we get one minus tangent squared of theta. So this goes as our double angle formula for tangent. So tangent of two theta is equal to two tangent of theta over one minus tangent squared of theta. And here at the bottom, you can see kind of reduced down all of our double angle formulas for sine, cosine, and tangent, the three different versions for your cosine. All right, hope this helps in making sense of where the double angle formulas come from. Good luck.